All right, as if you didn't know, the Iowa caucuses were just 1 week away. We welcome Arkansas Governor Sarah Huckabee, who was planning the stump for former President Trump in Iowa, but she had some problems with the weather. I'm going to have to come out there and get you some snow plows or something. Governor Sarah Sanders, welcome back to the show. Can I ask you a question? I know it's plowing old ground, but you're senior staff in the White House. You're in touch with the Situation Room. You knew that you were working for a guy, President Trump, who just might call you, you know, any time, day or night, and often did. How do you lose a defense secretary, Governor Sanders? How do you lose a defense secretary for almost a week?
You know, it is beyond my comprehension, like you, having worked in the White House. They can find you literally anywhere. And not just they can, but they do often. And the idea that the Secretary of Defense was hospitalized and the White House didn't know and the president wasn't aware is truly beyond comprehension. However, it is sort of seems like it may be status quo for this place. Joe Biden doesn't know where he is half the time, so it's not surprising that he wouldn't also know where his staff is. It's another reason that it is so important that over the course of the next week, we make sure that people in Iowa and then across the country get out and vote for Donald Trump, because we cannot continue down the path and allow our country to be guided by somebody who doesn't know where he or his staff are and how to lead the United States.
You know, one night, you will remember this because you were consoling me. On a Sunday night, fairly late, I was tracked down in a movie theater in Washington with my saintly wife because he didn't like something I said on one of the Sunday talk shows. So I tried to go missing.
That doesn't sound like you, Larry.
No. It was in the West End on N Street, and they found me. That's why this whole Lloyd Austin story is so implausible. Anyway, I'm laughing now. I wasn't laughing then. Sarah, let me ask you something. Nikki Haley, you know, she's fighting hard, okay? I'll give her a lot of credit. But she says, God bless Donald Trump. This is just last night, I think, she said this. God bless Donald Trump, who's just having a temper tantrum about me every day. Do you react to that? I mean, I don't know what she's getting at. And this is somebody that worked for Mr. Trump, who pledged allegiance to him, said she wouldn't run against him. What does she mean by that?
You'll have to ask her what she means by that. It's very unclear what temper tantrum she's talking about. I think he's probably pretty happy because he's looking at the same poll numbers that the rest of the country is looking at, where he is dominating in Iowa, has a commanding lead across the country, and is set and poised to win this primary at this point pretty easily. I think there is a very clear contrast between the story of 4 years of this country under President Trump versus the couple years that we've had under Joe Biden. One is a story of success and prosperity and security, not just at home, but abroad, secure borders, a booming economy with great trade deals versus somebody who has literally screwed up in every place that they've engaged. That contrast is very clear. The poll numbers reflect it. I don't think President Trump's having a temper tantrum. I think he is living the high life and pretty excited as he goes into the final days before the first votes are cast. That will put him further solidifying him as the nominee for the Republican Party.
You know, Sarah, as you're saying this, it's just something that I've said repeatedly in recent months, really almost all last year. Trump's running on the issues. And it's made a terrific difference. I mean, I think he's the clearest, whether it's the economy, taxes, regulations, drill, baby, drill, the southern border, strong foreign policy. I mean, I assume that's why you're putting yourself out to go to Iowa or wherever else you're going to campaign for him. I think Nikki Haley should be very careful because I think Trump's record on the issues and his promises that he'll do more of the same if elected.
Absolutely. He set out when he first ran in 2016 with a very ambitious agenda, and then he actually delivered. He gave the goods, and that's why his numbers are where they are. There is, again, a very clear contrast between the two candidates. You know, I think a lot of people in 2016 thought that Donald Trump was all talk, but then he showed that he could actually show up, do the job, and deliver on that really ambitious agenda that he laid out. He's doing that again. He is really, I think, hammering home where he succeeded as president, and that's why he's doing as well as he is.
All right. Governor Sarah Sanders of the great state of Arkansas. Sarah, thanks for coming on.